All right, and here's the solution. To start off, let's look at our forecast fragment query. Since it's a join between two tables, it's really easy for us to add additional parameters to our query. Now we make sure we keep the column indices consistent. Now we've grabbed the latitude and longitude at the same time we're grabbing our weather entries. The next thing to do is to move the function open preferred location in map over to forecast fragment. Instead of using shared preferences to get these values, we can actually get the cursor from the forecast adapter. We can get our cursor, move to a reasonable position, and then build our new string, which is just latitude colon longitude. We'll leave our comment where it was. Finally, we just have to fix up a few things in the code. And that's it. Well, at least for the code. We still need to do some work in XML. Let's move this r.id.actionMap now over to forecast fragment. Inside of it, on options item selected. And now we've got to do some XML work. Let's look at our main menu. We'll just pull this action map item out, and we'll place it right into forecast fragment. All right, one more thing to do while we're here. One of the things Reto talked about was wanting to get rid of the refresh menu item. So let's just comment it out. When we remove that action refresh item, we should probably comment it out from our source code too. After all, you never know when you'll want to use that for debugging. So there we have it, our final app, no longer having a refresh button, with a new exciting setting to turn off and on weather notifications. Details are taken care of. I hope you've enjoyed building Sunshine. There's still lots of things left to do in Sunshine. For example, we could also add a lot more intelligent things to its user interface. And, of course, we could make it a lot smarter about syncing data. And I hope the practices you've learned building Sunshine will help you in all of your future applications.